Hello everyone, in this session I am going to explain the interview question: what is overloading in Java? So what is overloading in Java? To explain this, let me start like this. Methods are constructors having duplicate names are allowed in the same class. Inside the same class, okay, by default you cannot allow the methods or constructors having the same names, right? Java will not allow you to create duplicate methods or constructors having the same names, okay, having the duplicate names inside the same class. But there is a kind of thing where you can create the methods or constructors having the duplicate names inside the same class when they have different parameters count or different parameters declaration or different order of parameters. Any of these three things, guys, okay? Any of these three things, if they have, Java will allow you to create the methods or constructors having the same names inside the same class. Okay, this concept is known as overloading in Java. Okay, so what is overloading in Java? Creating methods or constructors having duplicate names inside the same class by changing them in terms of the number of parameters or the type of parameters and the order in which the parameters are provided. Okay, using these three techniques you can create duplicate methods or constructors having the same name inside the same class, and this concept is known as overloading. Okay, Java will allow you to create the methods or constructors having the same names inside the same class when they have different parameters count, when they have different parameters declaration, when they have the order of parameters in a different way. Okay, this concept is known as overloading. You can explain in any ways, guys, whatever the three ways I explained just now. You can, in your own version, you can mention the same thing until and unless your context is understood by your interviewer. Okay, it's up to you. Now, to add more value, I will be providing more details about this overloading. Okay, you can even add this to your answer. Okay, overloading when applied to methods is known as method overloading. Okay, overloading when applied to methods is known as method overloading. Overloading when applied to constructors can also be applied to constructors, guys. Overloading can also be applied to constructors. When it is applied to constructors, it's known as constructor overloading. Okay, and the overloading is not only possible inside the same class. Okay, overloading is not only possible inside the same class, that is having duplicate methods or class constructors having the same name inside the same class. We are just calling that as overloading until and unless these three things are applied, right? But the same concept of overloading can be applied to the child classes also. Okay, for example, there is a parent class and child class. In the parent class, there is a method or constructor having some name, and with the same name there is a method or constructor in the there is a method in the child class. Okay, if there is a method in the parent class and with the same name, if there is a same method in the child class having the same name but with different parameters or with the different parameter declarations or with the different parameters order, okay, overloading is possible for the methods in the inheritance also. Okay, it should not be only in the same class, it can be extended to the child classes also. I will demonstrate everything to you guys. All these points, whatever I explained so far, I will practically demonstrate it for you. Okay, fine. Okay, let me create a new class. Let's say I will call this class as, okay, some xyz class. Inside this XYZ class, I will first start with the methods. Okay, method overloading I will explain. Let's say I will create a method known as public void method A. Okay, I'm just creating a method known as public void method A. The name of the method is method A. Okay, now if I create one more method, public void method A, with the same name and the same number of parameters, no parameters are there here also, no parameters are there, so what happens? Java will immediately give you some compiler error. okay, compile time error. When you hover the mouse, it says that duplicate method A in type XYZ class. That means Java is not allowing you to create the duplicate methods inside the same class. Okay, it's restricting you. But you can continue with the same name. Okay, the duplicate method names can be, there may be more than one method having the duplicate names until and unless you have the different number of parameters. If I say int A, okay, you see the error has gone away. Just because even though the method names are same, duplicate names are there, but here the number of parameters is equal to 0. Here the number of parameters is equal to 1. I mean, when you can create one more method, any number of methods with duplicate names can be created. Okay. So if I create one more method, again the duplicate error will be coming because here no parameters, but same name. So they are almost same. So Java will give you a compile error. Instead, if you say int A, okay, the error has gone from here but shifted to here. Okay. Since this method name are equal, and this parameter type, the declaration type of this parameter and declaration type of parameter is same, and here variable and variable are same. Okay. Now if I increase the count, okay, if I increase the count saying that string name, something I'm giving, okay, now it will become different. The number of parameters is different here. The number of parameters is different. Okay, the number of parameters is different. Now if I here only, if I write another name, I will copy paste this one and paste it here, it will get duplicate issue, right? But if I change it to a different data type, okay, instead of int, if I give double, it's different again. Either the count of the parameters should be different, or the type of the parameter should be different, the data type of the parameter should be different, okay. Or one more thing is, if I have this thing copied here, it will also give the duplicate error because this method A are same, here int is same, string is same. But if I change the order, guys, okay, I'll move this string name to the first and int A to the last. Okay, the order of the parameters is different. You see, here int A is first, here int A is last. Here string name is first, here string name is last, here string name is first. So in this, all these different ways, okay, Java will allow you to create the duplicate name methods until and unless their count is different, their data type of variables is different, okay, number of parameters is different, or the order in which the parameters are available is also different. So this is method overloading inside the same class. The same concept can be applied to the constructors, guys. Okay, now the same concept when applied to the constructors is known as constructor overloading. Let's say this is a class known as XYZ. In this, I need to create the constructors. Public return type will not be there, and the name of the constructor will be same as the name of the class. I just created a constructor here. Okay, the constructor. Now if I try to copy paste the same constructor here, okay, if I try to copy paste the same constructor here, it will give duplicate error. Okay, duplicate method it's saying, but it's a constructor XYZ in the type XYZ. Okay, so what you have to do, guys, just you need to differentiate in terms of parameters as we did for methods. In A, it will be different now. Okay, I'll be a bit fast here. Copy paste this one. Okay, now it will be duplicate again. I'll add more parameters to this. Sorry. Int A com string name. Okay, this will solve the problem. Now copy this and paste it here. Okay, and this both are same. Now I'll change the order. Control A comma. This will be different, even though number of parameters are same. Okay, and the type of the parameters also same, but order is different. That's why these two are treated as not treated as duplicate methods. Okay, because order of the parameters is different. Now the data type of the parameters. Okay, I'll copy the same thing. Here int A is there. If I change this to double A, the type of the data type of the parameters, if it is different, then also it will be treated as a separate method. Okay, this concept is known as constructor overloading. Now we completed method overloading and constructor overloading, guys. So now in case I will demonstrate the same overloading concept with as part of the inheritance, guys. Okay, for example, there is a class. Okay, there is a class public XYZ, and there is another class, class ABC. Okay, there are two classes now. This is class XYZ and this is class ABC. Here class ABC extends, okay, extends XYZ. Now XYZ is a parent class, ABC is the child class. XYZ is a parent class, ABC is the child class. So here if I create a method, that is public void some method A. Okay, some method A. Now if I copy paste this one and paste inside this child class, it will not give any error, guys. Okay, this will not give any error. Here method A is there, here also in child class also method, same thing is there. Why? Because this method will override this method. That will belong to a different concept known as overriding in Java. Okay, so if we have the same method inside the child class of the parent class, then the method in the child class will override the method in the parent class while calling the child class method. Okay, so but we are not worried about the overriding now, but overloading, coming to overloading, you can achieve overloading in inheritance also, like parent and child class hierarchy also. That is, you have method A here and if you have int A, okay, so now this method is said to overload this method. Okay, this method in the child class is overloading this method in parent class, because this has a different type of parameters or different number of parameters or different order of the parameters. Okay, everything matters. So the same thing can be applied in the parent and child combination also. Overloading can be applied to the inheritance also, but constructor overloading is not possible here. Constructor overloading is not possible here. Why? Because in class XYZ, you have to create the constructor with the name XYZ, right? And in the class ABC, you cannot create XYZ here, right? This will not become a constructor, right? Because in ABC, you have to give the class name for the constructor. Since the names of the constructor cannot be same in different classes, okay, cannot be same in different classes, hence it will not become a constructor, right? Until ABC, it will be constructor. If you give XYZ, it will not become a constructor. Constructor should have the same name as the class name. That's why overloading of constructors is not possible in the inheritance. Okay, in the inheritance only method overloading is possible in inheritance. I can write that point here. Only method overloading is possible in inheritance. Okay, so this will be enough, guys, for explaining, like whatever you remember, just explain as much possible as possible to the interviewer when they ask such kind of questions, so that you'll get a lot of confidence in your answer. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.